Word on the Run with Pastor Marius Swart.
Beloved, welcome to Word on the Run. We are in our seventh week of our 50 days to Pentecost. And this week we are speaking about the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, you and I must realize that Acts chapter 2 is actually a pivotal passage in the history of the church. Before chapter 2, the church was still coming. It was still in progress. But after chapter 2, the church has already been established. Before chapter 2, we find that the kingdom is still coming. But after chapter 2, the kingdom has already arrived. We see that before chapter 2, the Spirit came upon people sporadically and then left them again. But after chapter 2, we find that the Spirit has made his permanent dwelling place within people. And therefore, we have the constant presence of the Holy Spirit. Now, in Acts chapter 2, we find that God gives us the Spirit in 1 Thessalonians 4 verse 8. We find that we have the Spirit set into our hearts according to Galatians 4 verse 6. We see that we've been made alive by the Spirit according to 1 Peter 3 verse 18. We have been sanctified by the Spirit according to 1 Peter 1 verse 2. We've been renewed by the Spirit according to Titus 3 verse 5. And we have the guarantee of the Spirit according to 1 Corinthians 5 verse 5. We have the first fruit of the Spirit according to Romans 8 verse 23. And this is what you need to get into your spirit. So please order the material. Send us your email address and we will send it to you so that you can know what happened after Acts chapter 2 with us and the Holy Spirit. Now we are in day 43 of our 50 days to Pentecost. And we are speaking about the power to live in the Spirit. Galatians 5, 16 to 17 says, "So I say, live by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the sinful nature." He says, "For the sinful nature desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit desires what is contrary to the sinful nature. They are in conflict with each other, so that you cannot do what you want." So you and I must know what God wants. Galatians 5:25 says, if we live by the Holy Spirit, that means if the Holy Spirit we have, and then we have our life in God. The Greek word is the word zao. That word for life is the word zao, derived from the word zoe, which is the godly life. And that means to live. It means to breathe. It means to be among the living and not the dead. To enjoy real life. To be full of vigor. To be active. To be blessed. To have living water, to have the vital power in itself and exerting the same upon our souls. Ezekiel 37 verse 14, there the Bible comes and he says, God is speaking and he says, "I shall put my Spirit in you and you shall live. And I shall place you in your own land and then you shall know that I the Lord have spoken it and performed it. Thus saith the Lord." So, that Hebrew word is the word shachai, and it means to live, to revive, to keep, and to leave, and to make alive, to give life. It means to live, to nourish. It means to preserve life, to quicken or to recover life, and it also means to be whole. Now, life started when we accepted Jesus Christ as our personal Savior. And again, it was the work of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said unto the woman, he said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet he shall live," says John 11, 25. Paul comes and he says these words. He says, "I have life through the Spirit." He says, "I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live, I live in the flesh. I live in the faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself up for me," according to Galatians 2, verse 20. So he says, "The just shall live by faith," says Hebrews 10, 38. In Romans 1, verse 17, we must know that the just shall live by faith. Now, Galatians 3:7 says these words. He says, know and understand that it's really the people who live by faith who are the true sons of Abraham. Now, this life that we live also under grace and not under the law. Romans 8 verse 2 says, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made us free from the law of sin and death. The law of sin and death would have condemned us and killed us, but the law of the Spirit of life has given us grace and righteousness. Romans 8 verse 10 says, and if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. You and I must know that the Holy Spirit confirms this life. In 1 John 4 verse 13, the Bible says, by this we know and understand that we abide, we live, and we remain in him and him in us, because he has given us and imparted to us his Holy Spirit. Now, the Spirit himself also testifies together with our souls that we are children of God, says Romans 8, verse 16. Now, we are supposed to live a life according to the Spirit. In 1 Peter 4, verse 6, the Bible says, For this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to men in the flesh, but live according to God in the Spirit. Now, it means that we have to live according to his instructions. So if we live life according to the Spirit, we must firstly live it according to his instruction. Jesus said, the Spirit gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. The words I've spoken to you are Spirit and they are life, says John 6, verse 63. We must not only live according to his instruction, we must live life according to his desire. And we can have the wrong desires, and that's what the Bible teaches us. It's in Romans 8, verse 5, he says, for those who are according to the flesh and are controlled by its unholy desires and set their minds on and pursue those things which gratifies the flesh. Now, we are not supposed to live the life according to wrong desires. It says, now the mind of the flesh that comprises all the miseries arising from sin, both here and thereafter, says Romans 8, verse 6. He says, now the works of the flesh are manifest. He says, those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God, and says Ephesians 5, verse 19. He says, in the Lord's name, then I warn you. This is Paul speaking. He says, do not continue to live the life like heathens whose thoughts are worthless and whose minds are in the dark. They have no part in the life that God gives, for they are completely ignorant and stubborn, says Ephesians 4. So the right desires should be according to the Spirit. Romans 8 verse 5b, he says, but those who are according to the Spirit and are controlled by the desires of the Spirit set their minds on and seek those things which gratifies the Spirit. Now, there are four attributes of living in the Spirit, and those are, firstly, that we are according to the Spirit. So what I am, in the state that I am, is I am in the Spirit. We are controlled by the Spirit. So not only are we living according to the Spirit, we are also controlled by the Spirit. Our desires are controlled by the Spirit. Under his guidance, under his leadership, under his management, under his control. He says, but you are not living the life of the flesh, you are living the life of the Spirit. If the Holy Spirit of God dwells within you, it means to direct you and control you, says Romans 8 verse 9. We must also have the mind of the Spirit. So I must think according to the Spirit. And I must make sure that I have the mind of the Holy Spirit. And the mind of the Spirit is life and grace, says Romans 8 verse 6. And we must also set our minds and keep them set on what is above, says Colossians 3 verse 2. We must also seek the things which gratifies the Holy Spirit. So not only are we living according to the Spirit, not only are we controlled by the Spirit, not only have we set our minds on the Spirit, but we also seek those things which gratifies the Holy Spirit. He says, my desires And what I seek must gratify his desires. And this is what you and I must seek to do. This must be our aim that we seek. How can we gratify the Holy Spirit? We have been made, and we have been made ministers who are able to do what God wants us to do. And we must not minister the things of the letter. We must minister the things of the Spirit. For the letter killeth, but the Spirit gives life, says 2 Corinthians 3, verse 6. Let us pray. Father God, we pray that you will just, through your Holy Spirit, you will help us so that we can live according to the Spirit, that we can satisfy the Holy Spirit, and that the name of the Lord will be glorified in our lives. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.